Let's see how to use Skype function on LG Smart TV. Just first step, install the Skype camera VC400 on the LG Smart TV like this way and connect to the USB, because it's USB connections, so easy like this way you can connect camera. Let's step to access in a Skype from the Skype area on the Smart TV. Just click on Skype. Now you can get access. Of course you need to log in, and then you can find your contacts if you have already Skype account, or you can create account. You can add a contact by searching your friend's contact number or family member contact number. You can call your friends if they are online. Let's move to next option, call the phone. In your Skype account, it should be a credit available. Then you can call to your friends directly on their mobiles or their phones. History. Next option is, in history you can see all calls, log information will be available, voice messages and contact requests if somebody contact you. In calls you can see the call logs here, somebody give calls, how many times and who give a call, what time, who they are, all information there. In voice messages, if somebody leave you a voice message, it will be available, so you can hear that one as well. In a contact request, you can get somebody request you as a friend or a family member to add you. You can accept here. Let's see the next, my information. In my information, you can get your own status. You can change your picture, your profile and your account information. In my status, you can change your status, you can change your picture in change pictures. You can get a snapshot from the same camera, or you can use the logos to change as per your convenience. There are variety of logos, pictures, what you can change. In your account, you can get your Skype credit, your number if you have, or your voice messages, how many is there, or is activated or non-activated. It's all about your account information. Let's move to next setting. In setting, you can get a notification setting, call forwarding setting, privacy setting, video setting, and change your password. In notification setting, somebody give a call, then that time you can get a notification, or somebody online, somebody goes to offline, someone leave a voice message, when someone send a contact request. So all notification you can check or uncheck. It's up to you what type of service you require, so you can click on the yes and save it if you need it. Next is a call forwarding. When you are busy and you want to forward your calls, same as mobile phone system, so you can forward your calls. You can put the number where you want to forward, on which number. Next, privacy setting is about allow call from anyone or within your contact list. automatically receive video from your contact list or anyone. And show my picture to anyone or within my contact list. You can save this setting. Let's move to next, video setting. In video setting, you can set up your video camera. So you can adjust your video camera brightness, contrast and all settings there. The next is change the password. If you want to change your existing password, you can change in the setting option. You can put your current password and then put the new password. So summarize is contact, call phones, history, my informations and setting. The most important is that before you exit, use hide option instead of sign out. If you make it sign out, though nobody can be try to contact you because you already sign out. So must be use hide option. So while watching your TV, you can get a calls from your family or friends. Let's have test call. Let me see who is online. Okay, my friend is here online. I'm going to call him. The response depends on your and your friend's internet connection. You get a response from your friend, he accepted, of course he must have to accept, then you can able to view, otherwise the call will be aborted. You can change the screen mode as well to see how it looks if you want to do two window shapes, one is yours. Let's have a receive call. Okay, I'm watching a TV and now I get a call from my friend, so I can answer with a video or I can answer only voice. So my video will not accepted there. Now accepted with the video, so my friend can be view my video. You can change the screen mode as well to see how to look. Means you want to watch TV while using a Skype, it can be possible. Or you want to do one to one, yours and your friend camera, it's parallel, equal to equal. Or you want to do half screen for TV, what you watching, and you can use still a Skype. So four types of screen mode there. It can be useful as convenient to you. You can zoom your camera. You can point your camera as well as on the zooming direction. You can click on the previous original video or you can invite more friends in this conference call as a call. That's it.